Hi students, now I am going to teach 12th standard physics lesson 1 electrostatic potential energy for collection of point charge. So last class I taught electrostatic potential at a point P due to a point charge. So once again I recall that plus Q is placed at rest. P is a point distance or P is a point distance R from positive charge. So consider a charge is moving from infinity to point P. The work is done. The work done is electrostatic potential. Theoretic potential at a point distance r from point charge plus q is given by V equal to q1 by 4 pi epsilon naught r1. Now consider another charge q2 is bring or moving from infinity to point P distance r from plus q. Work is done. This work done is the product of charge Q2 and electric potential due to a point charge W equal to Q2 into V. So your work is done. This work is done happen when charge Q2 is infinity distance moving from infinity to point P distance or from positive charge, that is Q1 charge. So here work is done, that work done is equal to charge Q2 into potential developed due to a positive charge, that is W equal to Q2 into V. Substitute electric potential due to a positive charge V value in work done W. W equal to Q2 into V. So Q2 dot V value Q1 by 4 pi epsilon R. So work done W is equal to Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught R. This work done stored as the electrostatic potential energy U up to system of charge Q1 and Q2 placed by distance R. So U represents electrostatic potential energy equal to work done equal to Q2 V equal to Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught R. So finally electrostatic potential energy of two charges U equal to Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught R. So here electrostatic potential energy depends only on the distance R. Next, this electrostatic potential energy U equal to Q1 Q2 by 4 pi epsilon R is good for charge Q1 is bringing from distance R, Q2 is rest, or Q1 is rest, the charge Q2 is moving from infinity to point R, or both charges Q1 or Q2 is moving from infinity distance to R. Now to calculate the electrostatic potential energy in three charges, so bring the three charges one by one to arrange the configuration. So Q1 charge, Q2 charge, Q3 charges. So charge Q1 is bringing from infinity to point A. No work is done because initially no charge is present around the point A, so there is no work done. Then Q2 charge is bringing from infinity to point B, your work is done. So that work done W equal to Q2 into V1B. So the charge Q2 is bringing from infinity to point B against the electric potential developed by the charge q1, that is v1b. So w u1 equal to q1 q2 by 4 pi epsilon r12. So r12 means distance a and b, two charges distance r12. Then the charge q3 is bringing from infinity to point C against the electric potential energy experienced by the charge q2 and the charge q1. So works done, the electric potential energy u2 equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught electric potential energy developed by the charge q1 and charge q3 and charge q2. So this equation 2. So add equation 1 and 2, we obtain electric potential energy of system of charges u equal to u1 plus u2 equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q1 q2 by r12 q2 q3 by r23 q1 q3 by r13. The stored potential energy U is equal to bringing or assemble the charges Q1, Q2, Q3 to given location. So here Coulomb force is conservative force. The potential energy is independent of configuration of charge arrive at it.